So the iteration is p to the t plus 1. Do we have time to finish? Yeah, just enough. Is equal to df times pt, right, plus v. So it looks we are still stuck because df is this gigantic matrix that involves all the channel attenuations, right? So it looks impossible to get it in a distributed way, but if you multiply, look what you get. Pt plus 1 is equal to, what is df times pt? Well, that's gamma I, right, when you multiply, remember what, where is the matrix, df, 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 here it is, d times f, the product of these matrices. First I multiply by this, and then the results by gamma. So the upshot is gamma I times sum, I is not equal to j, gij divided by gii times p iteration t. Right? If I look at each coordinate, so let me look at ith coordinate, right? Plus gamma I times eta I divided by gii. When I multiply this times pt and multiply by this, I get precisely this. But what does this say? This says the following, that I can write it as follows. A little trick here. Gamma I, and here I'll put, take gi out, and I will put here sum I is not equal to j. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply by pi t and divide gii by pi t, right? And then I'll have here gij pi t plus gamma I, gamma I eta I. But what is this? What is this? This is equal to pi multiplied by gamma I, and this is precisely interference. Right? And this is precisely the signal, right? So this is nothing but pi times gamma I divided by reciprocal, right? Because it should be this, or should be on top, this on bottom. Signal to interference ratio. Let me see, am I missing? Signal to interference ratio at instant t, right? So look what I got. All I have to do is, in my next time slot, I only need to know what my target gamma I is, and just my own signal to interference ratio. So if signal to interference ratio is higher than the target, right, this will be smaller than I, so smaller than 1, so I will attenuate, I will reduce pi. If signal to interference ratio is something larger than gamma I will appropriately increase pi. So to find the global optimum, p star, all I have to do is measure my signal to interference ratio, divide the target by this, and multiply my previous time at instant t power by this factor. Right, so I just compare how I'm doing comparing to my target, and I adjust power trying to bring it precisely this to be equal to 1. So you see, it's a collaborative game because I'm not trying to increase my SIR maximally. I'm trying to keep it as close as possible to the target. And then it works best for everyone. So look, this is a trivial, and this is what made the mobile phones possible. This allowed, this was a big problem, and it had a startlingly simple solution that essential that can be done in totally distributed way, in no time whatsoever, that nevertheless produces approximation of the global optima. Now please read this carefully and see where each bit intervenes, because notice this somewhat messy calculus is exactly, I mean, it's almost the same as what we did the page ramp. So actually very few tricks from matrix algebra get you very far, right? And it's not that you are using, I don't know, distribution theory and Lebesgue integration and whatnot. It's basic algebra that enables incredibly successful engineering. But without this, simply mobile phones wouldn't work. So this is worth gold, right? This is a practical problem solved in an incredibly simple distributed way and enabling the advent of mobile telephony. Okay, so next time we will see how to get gammas using error correction codes. Okay. Please read the notes and the textbook. This is what runs today and what computer scientists code. You know, you don't code a word processor. You code something like this. And it's not a rocket science. Okay. It stopped the recording, right?
No, I didn't press.
Okay, so let's...